The quest was a brief one. A silver cream jug lay embedded in the folds of some zephyr shirts. "The cunning brute," said Mrs. Peter. "He took a cream jug because there were so many. He thought one wouldn't be missed. Quick, fly down with it and put it back among the others." Wilfred was late in coming down to breakfast, and his manner showed plainly that something was amiss. "It's an unpleasant thing to have to say," he blurted out presently, "but I'm afraid you must have a thief among your servants. Something's been taken out of my portmanteau. It was a little present from my mother and myself for your silver wedding. I should have given it to you last night after dinner, only it happened to be a cream jug, and you seemed annoyed at having so many duplicates, so I felt rather awkward about giving you another. I thought I'd get it changed for something else, and now it's gone." "Did you say it was from your mother and yourself?" asked Mr. and Mrs. Peter, almost in unison. The snatcher had been an orphan these many years. "Yes, my mother's at Cairo just now, and she wrote to me at Dresden to try and get you something quaint and pretty in the old silver line, and I pitched on this cream jug." Both the pigeon cots had turned deadly pale. The mention of Dresden had thrown a sudden light on the situation. It was Wilfred the attaché, a very superior young man, who rarely came within their social horizon, whom they had been entertaining unawares in the supposed character of Wilfred the Snatcher. Lady Ernestine Pigeoncott, his mother, moved in circles which were entirely beyond the compass or ambitions, and the son would probably one day be an ambassador. And they had rifled and despoiled his portmanteau. Husband and wife looked blankly and desperately at one another.